Hello dear, welcome to my channel. If you are new here or you are a returning subscriber, thank you so much for being here. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to make a cardigan just like this. If you want to know how to do something like this, then stay tuned till the end of this video. So to do this, I have already drafted my front and back patterns. So for this, the length of the back and front are the same, guys. The armhole is the same for the front and back. The shoulder for the front and back is also equal. This is because cardigans are usually free size. They don't need to be fitted or anything. So you can make both the front and the back equal. The only difference between the front and the back is the neckline. So for the front, we have the V-neck, while the back is just there. We came down by just 1 inch. Okay, so apart from the front and back patterns, there is going to be a sleeve. So I have 2 sleeves that I've cut already, and of course they are equal. One is going to be for the one for the left hand, and the other one is going to be, of course, for the right hand. Okay, so apart from the sleeves, we also have what we call the ribs. So this is what I'm going to be attaching to the wrist and to the neck and the waist. So to cut this, see, this is how it's going to be folded. You just fold it like this and fold it again and attach it around your wrist. So you can see the rib is shorter. I took out 1 inch. Okay, 1 inch, you can see. So when you open up the sleeve, that means it's 2 inches short. Okay, so we have 2 sleeves, so of course I've cut 2 wrist bands or ribs. And then another rib that I've cut is the waist rib or the waist band, and also this is going to be folded this way and also the other way, and it is short by 1.5 inches. It is short by 1.5 inches. Unfold, but when you open up this, it's going to be short by 3 inches. It's going to be short by 3 inches. 1.5 on one side and 1.5 on the other side. So let me just drag everything to one side so you can see. You can see, so we have about 3 inches more on the sleeve, I mean on the waistline. I don't know if you know what I mean. So your rib is usually shorter than the actual measurement. For the waist, it is short by 3 inches, 1.5 on one side and 1.5 on the other side. So now let's talk about the neck. The neck, this is how I've cut the neck, and also the neck is short. The neck is also short by about 3 inches by the time you put it round the both V's and the back. So guys, I've gone ahead to join the wrist. That's it, I've joined it like this, and I'm going to be folding it this way and cutting off at that point. See what I'm doing? So when you cut it off at this point, by the time you are folding this rib over, it lays very flat. There is no bulge at that point. Can you see? So just cut it that way and fold over. I'm going to do the same thing for this, the second wrist. I'll just fold it in the middle and cut that way. Please avoid the stitches so it doesn't open up. Okay, and then you fold it over so it lays down very well. Same thing goes for the waist. I've joined both the front and the back waist together. I'm going to fold it in the middle like this and cut off. I think that is too big, so I'm going to be cutting it one after the other. So I've cut this, and then I'll cut the other side, then fold over. Can you see? So I'm just going to fold it over like this, and that's how we are going to attach it to the waist. Okay, then for the neck, I'm going to show you a technique that will help the neck lay very, very flat. Okay, I'm going to show you a technique that will help the neck lay very flat. So this is the technique. Place it together like this and draw a V. Get the midpoint and draw a V. Then take it to the sewing machine and sew it on that line. I'm going to show you. So I took it to my sewing machine and I used the zigzag stitch to do it. The tension was so high, that's why you see it, it kind of folded that way. But no problems, it's going to be inside, so no problems with that. So now, see what I've done with the V. I'm just going to cut it off. Okay, I'm cutting that part off so that I will turn it over, and this is what is going to be at the front of the neck. Okay, so just cut it off like this, See, that's how we are going to place it. That's how we are going to place it. Okay, so it will lay very flat and smooth, and then we are going to weave all around just like we did for the other ribs. I'm just cutting it off closer to the stitches so it lays flatter, and you know, there is no tension anywhere. So be careful not to cut your stitches so it doesn't come loose, but try to cut as close as possible so you have a neat finish. So that's it. So I'll just go and weave it just like I did for the other ones. Then I will show you how to attach it to the front. So that's what we'll do. So I'm done weaving. So now we are going to be attaching it to the front neck. But before we do that, we need to join the shoulders. So I'll just take it to the sewing machine and join the shoulders like this. Then I have put a tack line there just to give me a guide when I'm placing my neck. So see what I'm doing? I'm just placing the V, the midpoint. I'm placing it at that point where I want to have my V. Okay, so that rope, that white rope, is just to guide me. I'm going to take it off later. So I'm just pinning it there, pinning it very well. Then I'll use my scissors to cut open that point. At there is actually a line, there's a mild line there that I can see, but you can't see it. So I'll just cut it to that point, open it up to that point. Then I would use my pins to attach. I've done that already, guys. So see, I've attached it all around. Okay, so the next thing is to take off that guide that I had. Okay, now I will use actual stitches to sew this down. So I've done that, guys. See how the V is lying so flat? It's not swollen or anything, so smooth. So the next thing now is to attach our sleeves. If you are enjoying this video so far and you've learned something, why don't you subscribe? Just hit the subscribe button. It only takes a second, and I am so grateful for that. Okay, so now I'm just going to be attaching the wrist and the waistband to it. Then I'll show you the result. I have attached everything, and you can see how it looks. The neck, the hand, the waist, and everything. Thank you so much for being here. See you in another video. Bye.